Okay, Mark here, you're causing unnecessary wear to your transmission. Try to take it easy or we're going to risk losing it. okay? That was a big one. Confirm you're okay, please. Engine off.
And with the cars now over the line, let's see our top three again. Verstappen, Leclerc and Valtteri Bottas. What an incredible practice session that was. But the fun doesn't stop here though. Join us again as the rest of the weekend unfolds.
Gearbox to take increased wear, just be careful.
We'll be right back.
what happened? Let me know you're okay. Are you okay? That was a nasty hit. Turn the engine off and wait for the marshals. He's only got 2 laps of fuel left. Those lap times are faster. You're down on your teammate. We've had to spend time repairing the damage to the car.
We're all ready for tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who'll be fronting the grid. Verstappen, Leclerc, and George Russell. With qualifying complete, all that remains now is the main event. We'll be live and uninterrupted for the Grand Prix tomorrow, so make sure you join us then. A proper road race, and in the true meaning of the word. That's how Mr. Monaco, the late great Graham Hill, once described this iconic event. The cars we drive have come a long way in the intervening half century, but still we race on those same public roads beside the Mediterranean. There's no victory more coveted than that of the Monaco Grand Prix. The astonishing Circuit de Monaco is, for all intents and purposes, virtually unchanged since its inaugural race back in 1929. The faster cars of today ensure the 19 corners past the casino and along the seafront remain as thrilling as ever. A 2.1-mile lap here takes us around an entire country, yet never more than inches from the race-ending barriers. It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he'll start from pole position, with Charles Leclerc alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Russell, Hamilton, Carlos Sainz, and Perez. Fernando Alonso, Norris, Bottas, and Yuki Tsunoda. Mick Schumacher, Magnussen, Daniel Ricciardo, and Vettel. Joe, Albon, Lance Stroll, and Nicholas Latifi. Iceman, and Pierre Gasly picks up the final grid slot. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track where preparations are underway. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into turn one, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It'll keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
After the points finished last race, let's aim to keep that momentum going. Okay, Mark here. You're causing unnecessary wear to your transmission. Try to take it easy or we're going to risk losing it. There's been an incident on track, but officials aren't looking to push for a safety car right now. Just be careful. MFD for a new strategy option. Up to speed now, let's get some heat into those tyres. Okay, we're monitoring some wear on the internal combustion engine. Be aware that we're going to start to see a loss of power. DRS will be enabled this lap. You can use it when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Try to stay with them. They might make a mistake and we could still regain the position. Check your MFD for a new Okay, we're hitting the rated limits on the MGUH. The power unit is going to be more prone to overheating. Wow, that was a heck of an impact. Let me know you're okay. Okay, gaps in the car ahead is 3.1 seconds. Okay, there's been an incident on track resulting in loose debris. Fortunately, the marshals have managed to clear it up in time and there are so far no plans for a safety car. There's a new strategy available on the MFD. Gearbox issue, but I'm afraid there's nothing we can do. Try and drive around it, you'll just have to hope for the best. Remember, you've got a lot of torque in these power units, so you should be able to stay in high gears for a lot of the lap. We're seeing a loss of power from the turbocharger now. Loss of power on the turbo. We're looking at some imminent gearbox issues, I'm afraid. Watch out for jams and missed gears. Check your MFD for a new strategy option.
away we go.
No problems there. Alpine will no doubt be very happy with that start.
That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Let's go. Blue flag, blue flag. Okay, blue flag conditions, create a gap and let the car behind through. There's a new strategy available on the MFD. Fernando's in the pits. We're not racing the car behind, let them pass when you can. That looked bad, are you alright? Let me know you're okay. Down before hitting the corners. We don't want to get a penalty. Blue flag, blue flag. Okay, blue flag conditions, create a gap and let the car behind through. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. I'm afraid you've been given a time penalty. Are you okay? That was a big one. Confirm you're okay, please.
It's the one that everyone wants to win, and they've only gone and done it. What a fantastic result here at Monaco. Anthony Davidson, What helped them deliver this result, do you think?
I think it was clear what the main contributing factor out on track was: speed. I know it sounds like an awfully reductive statement, but fast cars win races, and we saw that today with our winner.
The drivers are en route to the podium as we speak. What a fantastic win for the Red Bull team. They performed exceptionally today, keeping us firmly on the edge of our seats throughout the entirety of the race. Congratulations to everybody at the team. So let's review the updated driver standings. Well, it wasn't the best weekend for our championship leader, and their advantage at the top has been reduced. Let's focus on the driver of the day, Anthony Davidson. Who do you pick?
That's got to be the flying fin. Wait, how many flying fins have we had now? Anyway, I'm talking about Bottas this time. Just great raw speed and a good job in traffic as well.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. No change in the top spot then, but with today's points, their hold on that lead is getting weaker. Meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position. A strong weekend for them as they fight their way towards the top. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time out. Be sure to join us once again as we continue to bring you all the excitement of Formula One.